Thank you so much for tuning in for Hillcrest Kids, and I hope you had a wonderful week with your family. And I hope you are also staying safe and healthy, and I am praying for all of you. Well, today is Easter, and I want you to join me in celebrating Jesus' resurrection together. So we're going to have a lot of fun, so don't go away, stay tuned, and we're going to pray at this time and sing some songs unto the Lord. Let us all pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this beautiful day you have given us. And as we celebrate Jesus Christ's resurrection today, that I pray that boys and girls would know the true meaning of Easter, Lord. I pray that we will sing unto you, that learn something that is new to us, that we can be reminded of. And I pray that you'll just guide us through, and that the Holy Spirit of God will move our hearts this morning. Thank you so much for this time and all the boys and girls that tuned in, Lord. We love you and be with us. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, boys and girls, I want you to sing with me and my children. I will sing of the mercies of the Lord.
I'm not afraid.
Great job, boys and girls. Thank you so much for singing with me and my children. At this time, we're going to go into our Bible story. So if you have your Bibles, let's turn to Book of Mark. We're going to turn to Book of Mark, chapter 16. And 16 is the last chapter of Book of Mark. And we're going to read verses 1 through 6. So if you have your Bible with you, you can read along or follow along with me. Okay, I'm going to read Mark chapter 16, verse 1 through 6. And it says, "And when the Sabbath was passed, Mary Magdalene and Mary the mother of James and Salome had brought sweet spices, that they might come and anoint him. And very early in the morning, the first day of the week, they came unto the sepulchre at the rising of the sun. And they said among themselves, Who shall roll away the stone from the door of the sepulchre? And when they looked, they saw that the stone was rolled away, for it was very great. And entering into the sepulchre, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, clothed in a long white garment, and they were affrighted. And he said unto them, Be not affrighted. Ye seek Jesus of Nazareth, which was crucified. He is risen. He is not here. Behold, the place where they laid him." Well, today is Easter, and we celebrate Easter with our friends and family. Do you know what we celebrate on this day? Do we just celebrate Easter eggs and Easter bunnies on Easter? Well, those are what we do as an activity, right? But Easter is really for Jesus Christ. We celebrate Jesus' resurrection from the dead on Easter. Before we go on with our Bible story, let's recap what had happened last week in our story. Last week, we learned about Jesus coming into Jerusalem with on a donkey. He had a great welcome and praise from the people, and they all shouted, "Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest," and they laid their clothes and palm branches on the ground for him to trod. Then in the evening, Jesus and his disciples went into the upper room for a Passover meal, which was their Last Supper. Before the meal began, Jesus pointed out that one of the 12 disciples would betray him. And this person was Judas, and he left the room and to do what Satan led him to do. And Jesus and the rest of the disciples had their Passover meal. The bread they ate symbolized the body of Jesus Christ that would be broken for them. And the grape juice symbolized the blood of Jesus Christ that would be shed on the cross for them. When the meal was done, Jesus and his disciples went into the Garden of Gethsemane where they prayed. Now, let's talk about Judas. Judas Iscariot was considered Jesus' friend, right? He was one of the 12 disciples, and they, you know, worked together, they sang together, they traveled together, ate together, they taught people together, and prayed together. So the 12 disciples, they knew Jesus more than anyone on earth, and Judas was one of the 12. But Judas, he did not love Jesus as the other disciples did. People loved Jesus and believed on him to be saved from their sins. But there were also people who did not like Jesus, who disliked Jesus. And in fact, there were some people who hated Jesus and wanted to kill him. These people didn't want to hear that they were sinners, and they didn't want to believe that Jesus was God that would forgive them from their sins. So these people were called the religious leaders. They hated Jesus and they wanted to kill him. From last week's story, we learned that Judas left the upper room. And after he left the upper room, he went to go find these leaders. Judas went to go see these religious leaders who hated Jesus. And he told the leaders that, "I know Jesus very well. I know the places he goes. I know what he does. And I know everything about him. I've lived with him the last 3 years. I can help you finding him and help you in your plans to kill him. So the religious leaders and Judas, they agreed and they had a deal. And they paid him 30 pieces of silver for Jesus. The religious leaders, soldiers, and Judas went to go capture Jesus at the Garden of Gethsemane, where Jesus and his disciples were. Do you think Jesus was too weak to fight the soldiers and the religious leaders? No, of course not, right? Jesus had all his power to escape this arrest, but he chose not to. In Matthew 26:56, it says, "All this was done that the scriptures of the prophets might be fulfilled." So he had all the power to escape this arrest or even punish these people, but he chose to be arrested and follow these religious leaders because he wanted to fulfill the prophecy that was stated in the Old Testament. So the religious leaders tied up, well, the soldiers tied up Jesus and led him to the high priest. And there, all the religious leaders were already gathered to put Jesus on a trial. They accused Jesus of proclaiming himself as God and that Jesus was telling a lie. The high priest demanded, "I command you to tell me you are the Christ, the Son of God." Jesus answered, "I am." At Jesus' answer, the religious leaders got very angry. And the high priest, he got so angry, he tore up his clothes and he yelled, saying, "He is lying and saying that he is God. What should we do with him?" And all the religious leaders shouted, "He is guilty of death." So these leaders, they were not nice to Jesus. They punched him, slapped him, made fun of him, and they mocked him by saying, "Since you are Christ, why don't you tell us who hit you?" But Jesus did not say any word. Although he knew everything and knew exactly who was hurting him, he stayed silent. He allowed them to hurt him because he knew he had to go through this process to die for our sins. So the next morning, Jesus was brought to Pilate, the Roman governor. He knew Jesus had nothing, he did nothing wrong to be killed. But people and the religious leaders, they were all shouting to him, "Crucify him, crucify him." When Pilate saw that the people were so determined to kill Jesus, he washed his hands in front of the people and said, "I am innocent of the blood of this just man," which meant that he wanted to do nothing with this killing of Jesus. And he wanted to, he didn't want to be responsible for his death. So Pilate told his soldiers to take Jesus away and crucify him. The soldiers beat Jesus really badly and they made fun of Jesus. They put on a purple robe and a crown of thorns on him. They pretended to worship him and they mocked him. And after they mocked him, they took the purple robe away and gave him his own clothes and they led him out to crucify him. Well, but Jesus was so badly hurt that he could not carry his own cross up the hill of Golgotha. So the soldiers called the man that was passing by, which his name was Simon, and they asked him to carry the cross for Jesus. So Jesus, soldiers, and Simon went up the hill to the place called Golgotha. There on the hill, the cross was laid on the ground. Soldiers nailed Jesus's hands and feet to the cross. Then they lifted up the cross and placed it on the ground. Jesus hung on the cross and they placed a sign above his head saying, "The King of the Jews," to make fun of him. People passed by to look at Jesus, his crucifixion, and there were people who loved Jesus and who followed Jesus, and they were so sad to see him go through the agony and pain on the cross. But there were also people who made fun of Jesus, and they said, "You helped other people. Why can't you help yourself?" But remember, boys and girls, Jesus had all of the power still. He could have come out of that cross with no problem. He could have punished all those people who crucified him, but he chose not to, because he knew that he had to die on the cross for our sins. And when he died on the cross, he said, "It is finished." And the skies turned dark in the middle of the day, and he finished taking the punishment for our sins. He gave his life for us because he loved us and he wanted us to be forgiven. After he died, some of his friends who loved him came and they wanted to bury his body. His friend Joseph took Jesus' body and wrapped in the fine linen cloth and laid him in the tomb that he had prepared. When they closed the tomb, the strong men rolled the big stone in the doorway of the sepulcher, the tomb. The enemies of Jesus remembered, though, that Jesus had said, "I will arise again on the third day." So to prevent this from happening, they asked Pilate to put soldiers to guard the doorway, which was the big stone. On Sunday morning, the third day after Jesus had died, the woman who followed Jesus brought spices to the tomb to put on Jesus' body. As they were walking to the tomb, they were talking about who is going to roll away that big stone for us to get to Jesus' body. But when they got there, the stone was already rolled away and it was already removed, and the soldiers that were guarding the tomb were on the ground sleeping. There was an angel inside the tomb. He said, "Don't be afraid. You're looking for Jesus of Nazareth who was crucified. He isn't here anymore. He has risen from the dead. Look, here is a place where he was laid." Inside the tomb, the ladies could not find Jesus. His body was gone. Instead, they found the cloth that wrapped around his body. And Jesus rose again from the dead, like he had promised, and he was alive again. So boys and girls, Easter is not all about the fun activities that we do. It's really about Jesus' resurrection from the dead. We celebrate Jesus' resurrection because with his resurrection, we have a new life in Jesus Christ. If you trusted Christ as your personal Savior already, then you have a new life in him. He cleansed your heart from all your sins and gave you a home in heaven when you die someday from this earth. And he gave you a new life, and he is living in you, and he wants to have a personal walk with you and relationship with you daily. So let's thank him every day for your salvation, and also make the right choices for him and live for him each day. But on the other hand, Judas Iscariot did not make a decision to believe in Christ. In fact, he died without knowing Jesus as his personal Savior. If there's anyone that's watching right now that hasn't trusted Christ as their personal Savior, then I want you to make a decision today. Jesus Christ, he did everything for you already. He died on the cross and he rose again from the dead. And he is offering you a free gift of salvation. All you have to do is receive this gift into your heart. And it's simple as ABC. A, admit that you're a sinner. B, believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, that he died for your sins and he rose again on the third day. C, confess your sins, and accept Christ as your Savior. So if you have any questions or if you need help doing this, then please let your parents know about it. You can call me or one of the teachers at church, and we would love to help you out with it. But if you happen to make the decision on your own or with your mom and dad, please let me know about your decision so that I can congratulate you and praise the Lord for your salvation together. So that's all for today. So let's pray and we'll end our Bible story at this time. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for our salvation. Thank you, Lord, for Jesus who came to this earth and died for our sins and rose again on the third day. I pray that on this Easter Sunday that boys and girls would remember Jesus and what he did for our sins on that cross and how he conquered death and rose again on the third day. I pray that if there is anyone who hasn't trusted Christ as their Savior, would come to know you today, Lord, and help that person to make the decision today and let us know so that we can praise the Lord with you, with them. I pray that you'll be with us rest of the day, and may you be glorified and magnified as we celebrate Easter, Lord. We love you in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you so much for paying attention and listening to the story. Now we're going to play some review games.
Here are some review questions. Let's see how well you listened. How much did the religious leaders promise to pay Judas for helping them to capture Jesus? 30 pieces of silver. Where did the soldiers and the religious leaders capture Jesus? They captured him at the Garden of Gethsemane. The religious leader sent Jesus to the Roman governor. What was his name? His name was Pilate. Who put the purple robe and the crown of thorns on Jesus? Yes, the Roman soldiers. What was the name of the hill where Jesus was crucified? The hill was called Golgotha. What did Jesus cry out right before he died? He cried out, "It is finished." Who took Jesus' body to bury him? It was his friend named Joseph. On Sunday morning, what did the woman take to the tomb to put on Jesus' body? They took sweet spices. Jesus was not at the tomb when the woman arrived. Who was inside instead? An angel. What did the angel tell the woman? He told them, "He is risen, he is not here." That's all the review questions for today. Hope you got all of them right. Now let's play a game together. On each slide, I have letters that are jumbled up. Can you help me unscramble the letters to make a word? All the words are from our lesson today. Here's the first one. Jesus. Was that too easy? Okay, here's the next one. Judas is the answer. How about this? Pilate. He was the Roman governor. Can you solve this one? Cross, that's right. This one might be a little hard. Golgotha is the answer. That's the hill where Jesus was crucified. Here is another one. An angel. Great job! Can you unscramble this? Crown of thorns. Here's the last one for today. Empty tomb. Jesus rose again and his tomb was empty. Awesome job, everyone. Hope you had fun.
Boys and girls, thank you so much for joining me again. I hope you had a wonderful time singing unto God and learning something from the Bible and playing the games together. Let's think of Jesus as we celebrate Easter rest of the day. And I'm praying for all of you. Stay safe and healthy. And I'll see you next week at the same time, 9:45. Have a great week. Bye.